Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Welcome again to the shooting range in Rio de Janeiro for the second day of the competition of the ISSF World Cup Rio de Janeiro 2022. We are now presenting the athletes that are entering into the field of play for this final. Previously was presented Mr. Walter Robin from Germany, and then was presented in the firing point B, representing Thailand, Mr. Nopadon Suturovic. Now we have in the position C, representing Norway, Mr. Ole Harald Urs. Okay, so we have now in the position C, representing Norway, we see on the screen Mr. Ole Harald Urs, representing Norway. In the firing point D, representing the Republic of Iran, Mr. Sajjad Pusuruhin from Iran. He is 23 years old in this final. We are now ready for the beginning of this competition. Now in the firing point E, representing Germany. Welcome again, Mr. Christian Reit, the Olympic medal from Germany. Big support from his countrymates. The firing point F, representing France, 29 years old, Mr. Florian Fouquet. This is his competition. And the firing point F, we have here today a very special, it's our pleasure to be here with Mr. Felipe Almeida Wu from Brazil, Olympic athlete from the national team of air pistol and free pistol and other specialties here. Welcome, Felipe, how are you today? Okay, thank you very much to be here. We have Nicolas Moura representing the United States of America, very experimented athlete, and now entering into the range. We have from Slovakia, Mr. Juraj Tusinski in the firing point H. So, Felipe, did you make already the qualification stage, right? How was your day today during the qualification? Okay, well, we have now the Chief French Officer, Mr. Uwe Fuchs, representing Germany. We saw also Mr. Israel Gutierrez is the jury member in charge from Guatemala. Chief French Officer has already called to take your positions for the competition. Now, hi everybody in this is streaming, Mr. Felipe. And I thank you very much to be here again. So we are almost ready for this event. We are live. Please join us in the transmission. We are on Facebook, and Instagram, and Twitter, also on the website, in the official website of the ISSF. Welcome for this transmission, and tell your friends, tell everybody in your countries to join us for this Air Pistol Men 10 meters event. Thank you. So, let's start today with you, Felipe. How is your day by day? Okay, for example, I know that you are military, right? I know that you...
Not anymore.
Okay, you did your time already in your military career. So now what you are doing? Your sports, obviously, and what else? Okay. obviously also the family. So, Felipe, you were telling me about that you have no more longer a military career, so you have your company, you have working with pellets here in Brazil, your internet company, also you are training also in your sports, your family is correct, right?
Exactly, yes. I cannot only work, I have also to have trainings, because you see, it's difficult, they have good results, so I have to part-time to work and part-time to have training.
Okay, and now, this competition, the new formats. We have a new Olympic cycle for the Paris 2024, where the IOC already approved this format. Yesterday we saw in the competitions of the 10 meters high rifle men and women event, the format is three series of five shots, okay, in 250 seconds. After the third series, two athletes are eliminated, then another five shot series, two more athletes, so we have four already in the field of play, one more series, we decide the bronze medal. And then we go to the gold medal match, just single shots, 50 seconds each athlete, and 2 points. The athlete that made a higher score, 2 points. If there is a tied score, 1 point, and obviously the athletes can have 0 points if it does with that match. So, what is your opinion about this new format and also about all the previous formats that we had during this period of time?
I understand that the ISSF is trying to test new formats to make our sport more attractive to the public. And but on the other side, it's difficult for us as an athlete to understand what is happening, how it will be. For example, they just changed the format. I think it will be the first time with this new kind of final. And it's not so easy for us to get used to it, as they are changing so much. But I think now it's more close to how it was before, even with this medal match, like the gold medal match. With points, not with normal shooting score that we are used to. But let's see, it's difficult to say. We have to test like we'll see now. But I think it's better than the last format that we tried. So I actually like it how it was until Tokyo. For me, it was okay. But I understand that they are really trying to make something more attractive. So let's see if it will work or not.
Yes, I know that the intention of the ISSF is to have more attractive for the audience, for the people, easy to understand for them. For example, there are many children, there are many people that are seeing this competition. They don't know anything or just a little about the shooting. So it's difficult for them, and then in some cases, to know about the 10.9, 10.6. Why is 10.9? What is 10.6? What is 9.9? What is this situation? Can you explain me about that? How is the scoring in this competition?
Yeah, the more in the center, the higher the score with decimal score. So 10.9 is the perfect shot. 10.0 is just in the border of the 10 score. But really, for the public, I think what is complicated is that in some parts of the final, it's with decimal scores, and some part is with scores. So I think can be more complicated to the public to understand. But as I told you, we have to see how it will work. Let's see.
Okay, perfect. Now, this is the final. This is already the best top 8 athletes here. But previously, we have the qualification. So in the qualification, how is the competition? Is this in this range? Is it in another range?
So in the qualification round, we have in a different range. Actually, we have a special range for the finals. That on the same range, we have 10 meters, 25 meters, and 50 meters. So on the qualification range, we have the 10-meter range, where we shot a little time ago. And we did 15 minutes for preparation and cycling shots, plus 75 minutes for the competition shots. So we have 60 shots in total. and the best 8 shooters are here now in the final to decide who will have the medals.
Okay. Okay, perfect. So we have the best 8 athletes in the top 8. So are they already made the previous classification? So previously, okay, we are now in sighting shots. Obviously, we have these athletes are already doing their preparation for the audience. Felipe, we saw, for example, in Christian Wright here, we have in the first, they have something in the ear, something. Kind of special shooting glasses, right?
Exactly. The ear protection is actually more for the concentration, especially here with 10 meter shooting that there is not much noise, but it's important for the concentration. And for the glasses also, not everybody's using, but it's good to have a good focus on the sights and not to look over the target. So the glasses can also help. And they have also some visors, not everybody, but some shooters are using, to cover because they will have a lot of lights on top of the range.
Okay, perfect. We are now the first series, almost ready for the first series. Okay, Chief French officer has already called the load command and the start. So now we have 250 seconds for 5 shots in this first series. They are the coaches sitting behind of the athletes in this stage. We can see the score on every in the bottom of the screen right now. Okay. So, for example, the first shot was a 10.6 for Mr. Walter from Germany. Score in. Okay, we have a 10.9, 10.8 for the athlete for Iran, Mr. Pursain. Okay, it's a very difficult, a little difficult. Yeah, we know. Okay, in this moment, Felipe, you are a top-level athlete from Brazil. You are a silver medalist of the Rio Olympic Games in that time, and also in this time, obviously. How is your preparation to be here? I know that, okay, many people can say, oh, maybe it's too easy. I don't think that it's too easy. You have to have a mental skills, psychological skills, and also physical. Tell me about that. Okay, and for example, how many kilograms is the weight of the pistol in total, probably?
Normally around 1 kilo.
Okay, so we are seeing that the athletes are standing in that position with only one hand and 1 kilogram in his hand, rising to the target. And with these conditions, we have a high temperature right now, about 32, 33 degrees, plus the hydration and also the pressure of the final, correct? How do you deal with that situation during a competition and also the final?
So it's difficult. This is why you need to have some good physical preparation. So you cannot get distracted by the heat or because you're tired or everything. So you need really to be professional on what we're doing.
Okay, perfect. So we are already finished the first series of 5 shots in this moment. Mr. Pur Hossain from Iran is leading this first series. It's a tie with Mr. Robin. Now Mr. Robin takes the lead. In the first series, we have a tie in the first place with 51 points. In the third place, we have now Mr. Tusinski from Slovakia, just 1 point behind the first position. And the position number 4 is for Mr. Us from Norway, 0.5 points behind the position number 3. Position 5 is for Mr. Christian Reitz from Germany right now. It's just 0.3 behind the position number 4. And the position 6 is now Mr. Suturovic from Thailand. And position 7 and 8 is Mr. Foucault from France and Nicolas Maurer from the United States. So the difference right now is only from the first and the position number 8 is 2.7 points. Now we start the second series. Okay, the first athlete is now leading the competition, but many athletes are just back of the ranking in this moment. What will happen in the next two series, Felipe?
So they will make again a series of 5 shots. For sure, they are looking the results at the screen in front of them, so they know how far they are from the first places. And this is some extra pressure for the shooters, but I'm pretty sure that they are already used to it and they will be able to manage. So you can see we have Olympic medalists here, so they are already used to it. But it will be a nice competition.
Perfect. We can see in the... Okay, this is the pistol of one athlete here. We saw many stickers in their grip. What are those stickers?
So these stickers mean that the athlete passed through equipment control. So we have to check the trigger weight, the size of the pistol, the weight of the pistol, the grip. If the grip is not too big, it's not going through the forearm. So this means that the athlete already passed through the equipment control. And actually, in many competitions, we can see a lot of stickers in his pistol.
Okay, so as many stickers has the athlete, many competitions he has already in the moment, right?
Exactly, yes.
Okay, so what is the equipment control? Who does these measurements for the guns and also for your shoes, also for the lens and everything?
Yes, there is a special team, the jury team, to make this equipment control, and they check the pistol, the shoes, the shooting lenses. Actually, the cover of the eye cannot be wider than 3 centimeters. So you have to check everything, because after the competition, you can be selected for a random check. And if you are not sure that your equipment is okay, you have to make it before.
And what happens if, something is not right during the equipment control at that time?
Yeah, before the competition, you can adjust and get it by the rules. But if you are selected for a random check after the competition and you're not able to pass this check, then you are disqualified.
Okay, understand that. Well, if that is in the previous in the qualification stage. Now, for the final stage, I understand that the equipment control is prior the beginning of the final, right?
Exactly. Every athlete has to check the trigger normally before it starts the final.
Perfect. Now we are almost in the finish of the second series of 5 shots, 250 seconds. Right now we have, let we see what happened in this. Okay, we have Mr. Walter Robin from Germany is leading the competition. 101 points right now is in the second place. Is Mr. Tusinski from Slovakia, 99.8. The difference right now, just 1.2 points. It is the coach of Germany seeing the table. Now we have the table on the screen, and as I said previously, Mr. Walter is leading the competition. Mr. Tusinski Juraj from Slovakia, 1.2 behind the position number 1. And the position number 3 is Mr. Sayaj from Iran, 0.4 in the position number 3. Position 4 is Mr. Nicolas Maurer from the United States of America, 0.3 points behind the position number 3. 5 and 6 is Mr. Christian Reitz and Mr. Suturovic from Germany and Thailand. And they, in this moment, the more risk is for the athletes in the position number 7 and 8, Mr. Us from Norway and Mr. Fouquet from France. So, what is happening in the head, probably, obviously, in the head of the athletes that under the position 7 and 8 right now?
So they are pretty sure that they have to shoot better to have a chance to keep in the final, to not be eliminated. So it's an extra pressure, but also an extra motivation. So let's see how they will manage this. But we can see that the first place is really consistent in his shots, You see, he has a 10.1 now. He's really shooting good. Mr. Kuzinski, that was also a finalist at the Rio Olympic Games here with me. He's also having a good shot now. He's getting close from the first place. So I think they are really working hard in this final.
Excellent. Okay, obviously you have many years. How many years are do you have as a professional athlete?
So I started shooting air pistol in 2004, so 18 years I'm shooting.
Okay, 18 years, almost a life of a teenager. 18 years in this sport, obviously you know so many athletes. You can tell that many athletes that are in the field of play in this moment are your friends, I suppose, right?
For sure, yes.
Okay, how is the relationship with those athletes?
It's pretty nice. It's good to, because we see each other like 4 or 5 times a year at the competitions, but we also always have a good time and we always help each other. So it's really important for the Olympic sport that we have this fair play between. We know we are competing against, but we are also friends.
Great. So we have the athlete from France, Mr. Fouquet, in the screen right now. He seems so focused with the performance right now. To his left is Mr. Christian Reitz. We know that Mr. Reitz is a very experimented athlete, Olympic medalist also, like you. And many athletes say that Christian is the top athlete, is the main rival for I can say, right?
Yeah, he's really experimented and also he can shoot well, like all disciplines. You see, he's now shooting air pistol, so he will shoot rapid fire. He's also a finalist in London Olympic Games, if I remember well, in free pistol, that was Olympic. So now we have on the screen Jason Turner, that is also Olympic medalist, is a United States coach, a big friend of mine also. So we are here with big friends and good shooters. Really good.
Yeah, Mr. 10.9 right now for Mr. Pusuruhang from Iran. 10.9 right now, 138 until the moment. He's in this moment in the position number 5. In the position 7 and 8, we are very close. The next decision, so, first decision in this competition at the moment, in the position number 8. Fina is ending his participation representing France, Mr. Florian Fouquet. Excellent participation for the team of France. Congratulations for them. He finished. And in the position 7 also is the athlete from Norway, Mr. Us Ole Harad, also from Norway. He is now sitting with his coach. So he obviously in this moment is more relaxed when, okay, I finished. Maybe what this is saying, the coach and rich moment from the athlete of France and from Norway.
For sure, they are not so happy because they are leaving the final, but we know that they have made a good job. So they reached the final. It's always good to be at the finals. They are not maybe too happy now, but we are sure that they did a good job. Now we have Mr. Kuzinski, a big friend of mine, at first place, and Walter now is in the second place, but they are only 0.8, so you can see that everybody is pretty close from each other.
Yeah, the difference between position number 1 and 6 in this moment is just 4.1 points. The next athletes that are in risk for to be eliminated, oh, what happened there?
Yeah, he almost put the pellet on the wrong side, but he could manage to adjust it.
Okay, what happened is for just one mistake, the bullet is in the wrong way.
If he has time, he can take it out with the safety flag, because otherwise the shot will not be so precise.
And if he cannot take it away from the gun?
Then he will shoot and ask to be lucky.
Well, we have that doesn't happen. That doesn't happen anymore. 6 athletes remaining in the competition. In the first place, Mr. Tusinski. Second place, Mr. Walter Romin. 10.7 for Mr. Tusinski. He's strong in the leading of the competition. And in the position number 6 is Mr. Suturbis from Thailand. And from Iran is for Mr. Pusuruhain from Iran. the difference between both competitors right now is just 1.7, the difference we have in the screen from Mr. Suturubik from Thailand. He looks calm, he looks nice. Now, changing the table right now, Mr. Robin Walter from Germany is taking the lead. 10.8 for Mr. Busuruhain from Iran. Almost we will know the athletes that are in the position numbers 5 and 6. But for those athletes that are in the top of the ranking right now, you have been in the position. What do you think in that moment?
I think when you go further in the final, you get a little bit more relaxed. This is what I feel. So, of course, it's not an easy situation, but at the beginning, you are a little bit more with stress, but when it goes by, you can feel a little bit more relaxed and more focused on the shooting and not on the pressure of the competition.
Great. How about the uniforms of the athletes? We can see that all the athletes are with the national teams, for example, from Germany, from Thailand, also from the United States of America. Is that now part of the rules?
As far as I remember, yes, it's part of the rules. Also, but they are not with complete uniforms, but they, at least I think they have to wear a shirt with the country's name.
Also, for the Olympic Games, I understand that the rules for the Olympic is more strictly, okay? It's more the juries and all the people involved with the competition are taking more care about it.
Exactly. You have to wear the uniform, and also for Olympic Games, because of the sponsorships, you cannot show so many brands. You have to cover if you have the same brand appearing 2 times. So they are, the rules are more strict. Yes.
Four series right now in this moment. Next decision in the position number 6. Now we have the representative from Thailand, Mr. Nopadon Suturovic, is ending his participation in the 10 meters air pistol final event. Congratulations for him and for Thailand. He's happy. He's with his hand. Okay, now I finished the competition. His coach is now congratulating him. In the position number 5, representing Iran, Mr. Sajjad Busuruhain. His coach is happy also. He is happy. Now he looks relaxed. He looks happy.
Yeah, I think he's happy with his participation. He's a young athlete, so I think he's pretty happy with his performance. Of course, everybody wants to get a medal, but it's a good position, 5th place.
Okay, Mr. Tusinski is now in the position number 1. In the position 2 is Mr. Walter from Germany, 0.4. Position 3 is Nicholas Mohrer from the United States, 0.8, the difference. Behind the 2nd place in position number 4 is Mr. Christian Wright. The difference between the position 1 and 4 is just 1.3 points. So anything can happen right now. The public, the audience get louder and louder through the final. In this moment, the athletes, okay, I know that I am very, very close for the medals. The audience now start to clouding with their hands. It's more pressure in this moment for them.
Normally, yes, but we have to get to it. You see, now we have Christian Heitz, 10.8. Now he's showing how experienced he is. Good shooting for him. But also, I think every time they have to remember to focus on the what really matters, that is shooting. So even with the audience making more noise, I think they have to work to keep focus. Now on the 1st place, Mr. Walter, but actually there is a tie on the same play on the 1st place. Yeah.
Yes, now it's a tie in the 1st place of Mr. Christian Wright. The 2nd shot was a 8.9. Not good for him, this 8.9. Obviously, he's now in the 4th place. And the 1st place is now Mr. Walter Robin. Also, Mr. Tusinski in the 2nd shot has a 9.6. At this level, what is a good score for the athletes? What is not a good score? Definitely, I suppose that 8.9 is not a good score for the final.
For sure it's not. Actually, everything about 10 points, above 10.0 is not bad, but it will always depend on the other shooters. You see, Normally, in shooting, the qualification round, you are only competing against yourself because you cannot see the other's result. But at the final, you can see the result, the screen, the positions, so it's a little bit more pressure.
Yes, because so the announcer and the jury and the audience is telling you, hey, this athlete is in the first place, you are in the fourth place, so the audience is getting involved. The two German athletes in the front of the screen, all the team of Germany support them. And Mr. Nicolas Maurer right here. For example, Mr. Christian Reich has a very big earmuff, but Mr. Maurer has just a little pieces inside the ears. Right? Why?
Probably it's about comfort. When you're not feeling comfortable, you not use some big earmuffs like you see Mr. Kuzinski is using. I also like to use not because of the noise, but because of concentration, because it holds better the noise from the audience.
Okay, remember that at the end, there is a German time. The German team is supporting the athletes. So 25 shots after the short number 25, we will know the fourth place and also the bronze medalist in this moment. Okay, Christian Reitz, 10.4. Also, Mr. Walter, 10.8. He is now Mr. Christian Reitz in the third place. So he's continuing the competition in the position number 4. It will be now eliminated, the athlete from the United States of America, Mr. Nicolas Maurer, because he has 249.8, and Mr. Christian Reitz with 250.3 is winning the bronze medal in this match until the moment. Yes, time is over in this series. Decision, yes, correct. And the position number 4 is Mr. Nicolas Maurer from the United States of America. Congratulations for him. That we are seeing, what is he putting in the gun? Okay, the audience in this moment support them.
So he has to insert a safety flag to show that it's empty. And what is interesting is that you have now Christian Reitz with the bronze medal. You see a rapid fire shooter getting a medal in air pistol. And he was also finalist at the Tokyo Olympic Games. So he's really shooting well in air pistol also. And Mr. Nick Maurer, that was fourth place, he probably will shoot also a three-position rifle. And actually, his first World Cup medal was in rifle, in prone position. It was Olympic event before, and his first Olympic medal in World Cups was shooting rifle.
So you are telling me that this athlete, Nicolas Maurer, is a rifle shooter and also a pistol athlete, correct?
Yes, correct, and he's shooting pretty well the rifle, so I think he'll have good result here.
Well, it's not so common to have an athlete that is a rifle and pistol at the same time. I remember, I think that it was in the 2018 World Cup what happened with the medals in the prone and also in the air pistol. I think that it was in that year.
Every time I see Nick, I tell him he's a little bit crazy because to shoot rifle, we have to carry so many bags. I don't know how he can prefer to shoot rifle.
Okay, now we have, and now we are into the match points. We are in the gold medal match. The system has changed in this moment. Each athlete will fire a shot in 50 seconds. So, one shot only at the command of the chief French officer, 50 seconds. So one shot, the athlete that made the highest score in that shot will win 2 points, the other athlete 0 points. If they are tied, 1 point to each one. And the first athlete that gets 16 points wins the medal, the gold medal. So 10.7 for Mr. Tusinski from Slovakia, and Mr. Walter 9.3. So in this moment, the table is 4 points for Mr. Tusinski and 0 points for Mr. Walter Robin. So remember, the first athlete that arrives to 16 points wins the gold medal in this match. Obviously, the second place win the silver medal. The bronze medal was decided at this moment. For this time already, okay. I have one medal at least in the pocket, but do you want the gold, right?
For sure. I think everybody wants the gold, and They will work hard for it. It cannot be so easy. I think Mr. Kuzinski, he is more has more experience in shooting, but Walter, he's young and he's improving his scores at every competition. So it will not be easy for him at this time, but I'm pretty sure that he wants the gold also.
We can see, we can compare the face of the coach and also the face of the athlete. It seems to be like maybe sometimes the coach is more nervous than the athlete. You can see, for example, the coach of the United States also was a little nervous, but I suppose that is the pressure for their shoulders too.
It's difficult for who is watching because you don't really know what the shooter is feeling, so it's complicated, but for sure, the pressure on these two shooters are really high. So you can see now 9.6 for Mr. Kuzinski and 8.8 for Walter. So it's not because you didn't shoot well that you not get the score.
So we can see the coach is Mr. Kuzinski. He is, okay, come on, you can do it, you can do it. So that's what we are talking about. The coach is behind the athletes all this time, training with him. It's not just the athlete, it's their coach, it's their team, their physical, the federation, the medical. How many people it's behind the athlete for this level?
It's difficult to say how many people, but for sure it's a big team. And when you can see here, you have a good partnership between athlete and coach. This is also helping a lot. You see, a really good shot again for Mr. Kuzinski. For sure, they are really connected, the shooter and the coach.
10.5 for Mr. Kuzinski, 10.4 for Mr. Walter. Very good shots for both athletes, but two more points for Mr. Kuzinski. He's now 10-0. Timeout for the team of Germany. They are talking about, okay, we can see, okay, maybe she's saying to the athlete, you need to concentrate, you need to focus. What is she saying, probably? They are both laughing, but what they are saying?
Probably she's saying to him to enjoy his time because he's having a good result. For sure, he's feeling the pressure. It's not easy to be there. But I think, telling him to have a good time at this moment.
Other point is the coach of the, in this moment, when one coach asks a timeout, the other coach can go with his athlete and speak. Also, we saw the coach of the Slovakian team talking also with the athlete. Okay, you are good. You are very, very far away from the other athlete. You need to be calm. Just more three shots and you will win the medal. It's possible that they say that.
I'm not sure about it, but for sure he's asking Mr. Kuzinski to keep his focus, that he was good. You see now the 2 points for Germany, so the timeout really working.
Yeah, this is working. The coach is getting very excited with that shot, 10.5, very good shot. 9.9 for Mr. Kuzinski. We speak previously that any shot above 10.0 is a good shot.
And we can see here in this new final format how the coach can help the athlete. Before it was not possible, and now it's a really teamwork. It's really nice to see that.
It's important of the sport, the teamwork, the work for your coach. You need to be present with the athlete, supporting all these years working, all these years with the preparation for this moment. We can imagine only if we are in a World Cup, but we can imagine in a European Championship, for example, for this athlete or in Olympic Games, it's more pressure even.
Yeah, you're completely right. I think for shooting, the most difficult part is to handle the pressure, because when you see a big level competition, many, many athletes there is over this competition have a good shooting level. But who manage better the emotional will have a good result, a better result.
Let's go back in the time a little. You were here in the Rio Olympic Games. You were there in the range, in your country, with all that audience seeing you, the television and everybody. In the last shot, how was it?
It was a huge noise. Everybody was screaming, clapping their hands. You're making me feel a little bit nostalgic now. But was maybe some Unforgettable time. I see more 2 points for Mr. Walton now. 12-4. And at this time, I was really feeling the pressure, but I was happy because my friends were here. My part of my family was here. It was really nice to at this competition. Even with the pressure, I was feeling good.
That is important because you feel your support of your country, your countrymates, all the federation, everybody was, okay, go Felipe, you can do it. So we just can imagine the team of Germany, also the team of Slovakia, support the athletes. Now we have 12-4. Mr. Tuczynski leads the competition. In this moment, it's 16 points the match. Mr. Rubin is getting closer and closer at this moment, but 9.2 for Mr. Tuczynski. Let's see if Mr. Walter Rubin takes an advantage for this. And it's correct, 9.5. If not so good shots in this one. But it was enough for Mr. Walter to get more closer for the Mr. Tuczynski.
Yeah, that's the big difference in the final. You don't have to shoot perfect. You just have to shoot better than the other one.
It's more easy. Okay, if you do bad in the shot, okay, it's better for me. But obviously, you are not seeing the result of the athlete. You are seeing on your own sights, your own result, your breathing. And at this time, the heart beating is more higher and higher. And that heart beating, how is it feel in the sights on the pistol?
It depends on the shooter, but some shooters can get really calm and relaxed when they are shooting, even in the final. And some shooters, they have to manage to shoot more nervous. So the 0.1 difference. It's difficult to manage this when you are too nervous, but you have to shoot anyway, even if you're nervous or not.
Now we have a 9.7. It was not so good, but was enough for get another 2 points. So the difference right now is 8 points, 14-6. Mr. Tuczynski leading the gold medal match. Match point for Mr. Tuczynski right now. We are very, very close of the end of the gold medal match. If Mr. Tuczynski gets a higher score of Mr. Rubin Walter, he will win the gold medal. Now the crowd is clapping their hands, supporting the athletes. 10.0 is the first result on this shot, and 9.3. So the gold medalist in this moment is for Mr. Juraj Tuczynski from Slovakia. All the Slovakian team is right now getting excited, and he's very happy. Okay, congratulations for Mr. Juraj Tuczynski. Very good performance, very good work for him, and also for Mr. Walter Rubin in the second place with 9.3. He gets the silver medal right now. We can see now the team of Germany very happy for him, very happy for the athletes, so they are finished right now. In this moment, the pressure is more. Okay, we can see the smile in the face of Mr. Walter, also his teammate, Mr. Christian Wright. Congratulations for him. Well done. The three medalists right now.
Yeah, for sure was a really good match to watch. And Mr. Walter, he's young, and for sure he's pretty happy with his result. And for Mr. Tuczynski, I think he's really happy to have this gold medal. He arrived in Rio, I think, 1 week ago to have training, so he really worked hard for this medal.
He also, Mr. Tuczynski, is here in Rio training 1 week ago. So. Or more, or maybe more. Okay, so that is the result. You can imagine for these athletes to be here 1 week, far away from their country, far away from their family and friends, but the goal for them is this. This is the goal for the athletes. So the gold medal winner, Mr. Juraj Tuczynski from Slovakia, Mr. Rubin Walter from Germany is the silver medalist, and the bronze medalist, Mr. Christian Wright from Germany. We are presenting right now the medalists. He is Mr. Christian Wright, smiling for the picture. Everybody is happy right now, so we can just imagine the relief of those athletes, Mr. Tuczynski, have another competition, correct?
Actually, for sure, they are feeling that their mission is accomplished. So they came to have good results, and they managed the mental part, and they had good results. They got the medal. So they are, for sure, pretty happy with the performance.
Well, now closing this transmission. Thank you very much. There is Mr. Lissing talking with the people of the ISSF. So thank you very much, Felipe, to be here in this transmission. Thank you very much for participating with us. I hope that everybody that saw this final enjoyed. Thank you very much. Good afternoon, and thank you, Felipe, again.